We are going to analyze the different type of injection system in gasoline. We are going to analyze direct fuel injection, indirect fuel injection. We are going to check carbureted engines, throttle body, and fuel injected, direct fuel injection. And we are going to start with the difference in between direct fuel injection and indirect fuel injection. Danny, what is the main difference?
Well, in this case here, this is an indirect fuel injection. So how this works is...
This is the intake manifold.
The intake manifold, right?
The air filter is here.
And the air filter is there. And then this shoots it right in front of the valve, the intake valve.
Look, here is the head valves. The head valve is here, and those are the intake ports. And those are, Danny?
Those are the injectors.
The injectors, and this is?
The fuel rail.
The common rail. All right. Ah, the injector is on the manifold. It's not on the head. The injector is on the manifold. When the intake valve open, what happened?
It sprays.
It sprays the fuel here.
5 volts comes here and it gives the spray.
And that signal is coming from?
From the computer.
The computer. Oh, in the carburetor, you have air in the center and fuel here.
Correct.
And this equipment internally mixes the proportion 14.7 to 1. Here.
Correct.
Because they have a spring valve, yes, that we are going to explain later,
correct.
No? Okay. The fuel enter over there and the air enter here.
Yep, the accelerator pump, when you give it throttle, the accelerator pump will actually spray the fuel into the cylinders.
Okay, and this is the idle, no?
Yes.
The idle valve. All right, it's too simple, no, the carburetor?
Very simple.
And because the throttle body looks similar, what is the difference?
So the throttle body, what they did is, this was the transition from carburation to fuel injected. And so what happens is you have two main injectors. Just like your carburetor, the air comes in and the fuel goes in. They kept the same concept. But instead of having fuel being in a carburetor, it's actually spitting through the injector, giving the exact amount of fuel they need.
Ah, nice. In this particular case, there are two injectors and receive the signal 5 volts
from
the computer. From the computer. And there are other ones similar to this one with only one injector in the middle, no? Like the picture that we have on the screen.
Yes.
Exactly. That's nice, no? But the rest is equal. The throttle's
the same.
It's the same.
Everything's the same.
Ah, okay.
The only difference is it just sprays in directly.
Okay.
Into the intake.
But the people say that the TBI have a bad reputation. Why?
Yes, because what happens is it'll puddle up fuel into the intake, and also these injectors are very sensitive.
The carburetor works with a simple principle. The principle is the Bernoulli principle. The Bernoulli principle states that a fluid in a pipe, if you reduce the diameter suddenly, the speed of the fluid in this narrow area increases, because the pressure decreases. This is a misconception. The people think that in this narrow area, the pressure increases. No, the pressure decreases. Yes, my friend. In that narrow area, the pressure decreases and the speed of the fluid increases dramatically. This is basically the carburetor. The carburetor have a fuel. The fuel is on the tank, on the fuel tank. On the fuel tank, we have the fuel. And the fuel enter over there. The fuel enter over there. And the fuel enter in this compartment where the flow switch is located, only if this valve, the needle valve, is open. If the flow is in this position, the needle valve is down. If the float is like this, the needle valve closed. Yes, depending on the position of the float, the needle valve open or close, and fuel enter in this compartment. And now you have the level of this compartment here. This is important. Calibrate the float in order to keep the level of this compartment. And when the air enter at high speed over there, the air enter. When the air pass over there, the pressure in the middle of this element is reduced, and suction the fuel, and the fuel enter over there, and enter mixed with the gasoline at high speed, and this is basically the intake manifold. This is the intake manifold. banana, correct, and after that enter. If the intake valve is open, the fuel enter over there in the combustion chamber. Glenn, okay, this is for idles. And what about this one?
Okay, this, you're right, this is for RPMs, and this one here is for the air.
Air.
It's like a needle, and the more you come out.
Oh, this is the outlet.
That's the outlet. And the more you come, the more it opens up, and from the venturi of the air going through, sucks the fuel more.
When you tune the carburetor, you adjust this jet, no?
Correct.
And this one, of course, because
this one is for the RPMs, you adjust that. This you have to also, too. You really got to go into a manual, and because all the carburetors would be different.
Correct.
And see how many turns out. Before you take it out, when you rebuild them, you should screw it in to see how many turns it goes in.
Okay.
So then you know when you take it out and rebuild it, put it back together, you have a starting plan.
Oh, nice. And what about those hoses? Vacuum?
That's vacuum. Vacuum, this one here is going to a fuel pump.
And that's a fuel pump?
Yeah.
All right.
Now we are fuel pump.
We are going to disassemble that plate and we are going to check the fuel pump.
The diaphragm, okay.
Danny, I know that every day is less common the carburetors in outboards, but there are a lot of outboard with carburetors. Is difficult calibrate the flaps on the carburetors?
No, it's not. What you have to do is you have these screws here, all three, and the whole idea is you loosen them.
You loose and? Correct.
You loosen them all, and you have to make sure that all the flaps are closed. And then you tighten them, so that way they're synchronized.
The procedure is go to the closed position,
yep.
And you start to tighten at the same time all of them.
Correct.
Perfect.
And then once you tighten one, and you hold it, and you tighten the other, when you hold it, you tighten it.
Okay, after that you check the wide open throttle.
Correct. You check the wide open throttle, so when you give it full throttle, that'll tell you if it's opening all the way and closing all the way.
In other words, I have carburetors until 1990, basically, 87, 89, maximum. Until that point, we have carburetors. We have carburetors for a two-stroke. Remember, in a two-stroke engine, the carburetor mixed oil, mixed a fuel, and air. For four strokes, only mixed fuel and air. Those are the carburetors. After 1990, we have the TBI, Throttle Body Injection System. It's in between 1990, basically, and 1994. Only for maximum 5 years, the TBI was famous. The throttle body is basically an administrator of the flow of air. Loose, similar to the carburetor, but only have the flap to administrate the amount of air entering in the system, in the intake manifold. The throttle body with one injector on top, like the picture on the screen, is the first generation, of injection system. It's basically this element with one injector or two in top. This is the TBI. All right, we have the single throttle body in two strokes and four strokes engines. Yes, we have the throttle body at the intake manifold. Glenn, I have a question. This is the typical intake manifold of an outboard. Intake manifold, and the throttle body is located here, and those are the reed valves. In other words, the intake manifold is bolted on the crankcase.
On the crankcase.
It's the opposite, like a four-stroke engines. The intake manifold is on the head, no?
Correct. This is bolted on the crankcase because When the fuel comes in, it's mixed with an oil.
Correct.
Two-stroke.
Correct.
So it lubes your crank and everything first before you even fire it.
Correct. The air filter is here.
Correct.
And this is the throttle at that
TPS.
The TPS, the throttle position sensor.
For the computer.
And the cable control the input of air into the intake manifold.
And the throttle body.
Yes. Correct. And those reed valves are located in the crankcase. The crankcase is here. We have another great example about the throttle body. This is an intake manifold, Danny. It's a specific material. It's a special plastic reinforced, no?
Yes.
Have a similar characteristic like the typical cast aluminum, no?
Yes, very, very, very sturdy material.
Oh, exactly. Okay, and we have the throttle bolted over there. Danny, look at the throttle. We have one sensor here. What sensor is that?
That is your throttle position sensor.
The throttle position sensor.
And that uses also a 5-volt reference.
Correct. Coming from the computer,
coming
no?
from the computer. So basically, how this works is when you have the throttle closed all the way, you should only get like 0.47 to 0.5. And then when you open it all the way, you should get about 4.8, you know, 4.9, 5 volts.
Correct.
And this is how the computer knows how much fuel and how much of the timing needs to advance by using this TPS as a reference as far as where the RPM is.
Okay, guys. This is the TBI. The signal coming from the computer enter in the center of the injector. The injector is located in the middle of the throttle body. All right, the injector receives the signal in this particular engine. The reference is 3.7 volts. In the other video clip that we are going to check right now, the reference is 12 volts. Okay, this injector open, immediately the ignition switch is activated. The fuel enter at high pressure here, and the fuel return into the regulator. Fuel enter, fuel return, and the body, and we have a throttle position sensor here, throttle position sensor here, and we have the IAC valve, the idle valve over there, is basically a carburetor with one injector located in the center.